Lots of people have these tall ones. Now, I've got a chest one, actually, but this is beautifully packed.
Well, it's much easier to have one like this, and the trend is, in fact, to upright freezers.
These are the sort of things you think it's a good idea to keep in them, don't you?
Yes, these are things from my freezer. I buy rich cream cheese because you can get it in big packs. I have to go a long way, and they're quite difficult to get. Then you can get bought things like beef burgers for children, and then I use containers such as this one for apple puree to use windfall apples. Then scones, I make my own scones. That makes it jolly reasonable when people pop in, not going around the corner to buy cakes. Then special puddings. Do you remember we made a summer pudding?
I do indeed.
That's
yes,
the very
I've got one.
One
in my
and then you see you can put it into this bowl and thaw it, and I don't need to keep this one in the freezer. Those are some rowan berries that I picked and I haven't made jelly yet. And here there's 2 pounds of chopped peppers for 44 pence. I thought a good buy. Just take a handful and add them to a casserole. There's our tomato puree.
Those are oranges, are they there?
Yes, these are several oranges that I bought last week because they were a good buy. And I'll be making marmalade by the whole fruit method later on. And that's some bread, always to hand. Croutons, that's the cubed pieces of fried bread to add to soup. And you just take them out and heat them in the oven in a bowl. And then those are some crusts that I'm going to make into raspings. Again, I haven't had time to do it yet, Judith.
And crumpets, which are always a good standby in the winter, aren't they?
Yes, and you can't buy them in the summer,
no.
So you can save them and have them on a cold day in the summer. Then a good buy this week were some peas. These were £5 for 75 pence. That's 15 pence a pound. And I noticed that my sprouts were 15 and a half pence that I bought this weekend. And they would have quite a bit of waste.
They're always
so
a good one
a good
to
buy.
Have in anyway, aren't they? And fish too, that comes well in freezing packages, doesn't it?
Well, there are less fishmongers these days.
Yes.
And so you can buy all different varieties of fish and you can buy a big pack. It's a great saving, about a third on buying catering packs. And you can perhaps use 4 fish fingers, close it up again, and then use them later.
And smoked mackerel, which I find now is very much, people are loving it and wanting it all the time.
Yes, I buy the ones that are packed separately in polythene bags, and they keep terribly well. And kippers are an excellent buy on the bone, are much more reasonable than buying them individually.
What's the blue bag at the bottom? Should we take it over there and have a look at it? Shut that up. It looks a real hodgepodge, that.
It is a hodgepodge. There's always things in the freezer. I expect you've got them in yours. But really, you should have been, you use them up. You know, I always say that cooked dishes should be used up within something like 3 months. Well, this
what
stock
is that?
This is stock 4 months old, and it was moulded in something like that, Judith. Mm-hmm. And so it's a free container. And that's concentrated stock reduced down so it doesn't take up too much room in the freezer. And I made it from these chicken bones, and that's from 3 carcasses. And then when you're going to make it into stock, bang them hard with a rolling pin. That will crush up the small sort of chest bones and take up less room in the freezer. And also you'll be able to get it into your pan when you cook it. And some other things that I really ought to have used up. A pepper, and that's to remind me all in this bag. I've got some breadcrumbs down the bottom. And look what's here. This is a trotter that I keep meaning to make some brawn with. And so when I can get some nice reasonable cuts, I will make a brawn. And this will make the nice jelly for it.
And the pancakes, I know you had there, some pancakes. Oh, no, I don't know where they've gone, actually. They've got away.
They've lost, I think. And I've got some special sausages. And you mustn't keep sausages because they've got a high fat content. You mustn't keep them too long. And these are nearly 3 months, so I must use them up.
Now, you talked about the stock being actually frozen in this shape. And over here, we've got some containers which you must reuse. You must never really throw these away if you do have a freezer, must you? They're marvellous.
No, they're excellent. And they mould, you know, you've got 10 ounces or 5 ounces. And I use the containers that have had ice cream in. I buy some good quality ones because they really do last. A boil-in bag here is excellent and saves fuel.
Well, how do you use that then?
Well, say you've got a chicken casserole, you freeze the chicken casserole in it and perhaps some vegetables in sauce, and you'd boil your potatoes in a pan with water and you'd drop the 2 bags into it and they would reheat from frozen without any waste. And buy good quality ones, you can wash them and reuse them. And then you can use these free cartons here. Jelly moulds that you buy mousses in. We reuse. I make my own mousses, and that's more reasonable. I keep little butter ones for putting something like chopped herbs in. And I don't buy these collapsible. They're quite expensive, these. I use
what, that's for blanching things like sprouts, you mean, or whatever? Mm.
I find much better is to use one of these wine straining bags from a large chemist. And it fits the side of the pan beautifully, and it is, I think, more efficient. Mm. And I do buy these foil dishes. I find them good. You can reuse them. I soak them well before it helps to clean them.
Because initially, of course, they're fairly expensive, but as you say, you can reuse them as long as you've washed them properly. The only problem I find with them is that once I've washed this lid, it gets rather floppy and bendy, and I'm not sure that it'll, you know, stand the strain of going back in again.
Just put foil over the top.
Really?
And tuck it in all round with a little twist, like you would for your Christmas pudding.
Mm. What about these big bags you've got here?
These huge bags, I think, are an excellent buy, and you can go on using them for about 2 years. Now, I keep all fruit in this big yellow one, and meat in red ones, and fish in blue ones, and particularly if you've got a chest freezer, because it's liable to get lost in that big chest, you know, and you look in and you can sort of see, oh, there's a yellow one.
And you know that's fruit in.
Yes.
Yes. Well, you've got all these tips, I know, that I've read with great pleasure in your two books here on freezing, Mary. There they are, you've two of those. And also, of course, which I think are absolutely super as well, are these Home and Freezer Digest books, because they're only 15 pence, and they're issued, what, once a month, isn't it?
Once a month, and I think there's lots of cooking ideas that save money.
Because you actually can save money on freezing. It's a very good thing to do if you can.
Yes.
And the convenience, of course, is unbeatable.
I wouldn't do without it.
Well, Mary, thanks very much indeed for all this tips.